Good day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another fun, fast project. So let's get cracking. Friends, it's time for a fantastic sim lab project, so let's hit create new 3D design. Friends, we are going to call this Trigger Launcher. Now you can create this to launch anything you want. Dominoes, marble runs, I am just going to make the launcher and give you a way to start exploring. So the first thing I want to do is make the area I can work with larger. I'm going to change it backspace to 600 and then backspace again 600 and hit close settings. Gives me much more room to play. Friends, we're going to build this with the wedge. When you bring it out, I want that angle facing me, so let's just use mirror. I want you to change the measurements. We want this to be 60 and press enter. We want this to be 50, press enter, and let's leave the height at 20. So that's going to be our launcher base. Now we're going to add a middle and some walls. Check out how slick this is. If we bring out a cube, we can set it right on that slanted face using the cruising tool. We're then going to make it 1 millimeter thick. Zoom in. I'm going to orbit and look at it from a corner. I want this to reach almost the whole way, so we're going to change that distance to 45 and press enter. And then I do not need it to be 20 high, I'm going to change it to 10. I'm going to take that piece, I'm going to select it, I'm going to do L for align. I want the blue one to be the boss, and I want it to go to this edge, and I'm going to put it in the middle of that area. That is pretty nifty. Notice it did sink in. I'm going to do W for work plane, and I'm going to hit D for drop, and I'm going to bring that to the top edge because that's where I wanted it. I'm going to do Control D. Let's nudge across with those arrow keys, and I'm going to do Control D again, so I have three of them. I'm going to select the one in the middle, do L for align, click the middle wedge, and bingo, it's aligned. Now I'm going to just select the last two, once again press L for align, and this time I want them to go to that edge. Friends, we're going to take that whole chunk and do Control G to group it. This is our launching area. Now we need to put the work plane on the ground. Once again, W for work plane, click out here near the edge, and we need to cut in what we're going to use for a trigger. Well, we're going to use a normal cube. We are going to keep this 20 measurement. We're going to change it to 3 millimeters thick. We are going to do Control D to make two of those. And then we are going to nudge them away from each other. We are going to use the sweet ruler tool to set a measurement. I'm going to tell you to set it on any corner, click on that shape, and then change the numbers to 0. And notice this measurement is the 3 for the thickness. This measurement is the distance. It is green. We're going to make it 0. So now this part is right on that corner. If we click on the shape, you can see it is size 20. So now I'm going to click on this shape. I want this distance right here to be negative 50. That chooses the gap between them. And then I want this distance to be 0. Check it out. They're now exactly lined up with that corner with a gap in between it. And here's one of my favorite parts. Now that we've got them lined up, we can easily change that to negative 45. And bingo, it snaps into place. This ruler is amazing. Now friends, I'm gonna close the ruler. I'm gonna take those two shapes and I'm gonna choose Control G or group. Now friends, let's line this up. If we select those two, choose L for align. Of course we want it in the middle. I'm gonna tell you to click on the blue one and let's go to that front edge. Now we need to back this up. We're gonna change our nudge to 5 millimeters and we're gonna nudge it back 1, 2, 3 clicks, which is a total of 15 millimeters. We do want to make sure it pokes through the bottom, as you can see it does. And then we're going to duplicate this. Control D. Take the second one and make it red and lock it. Notice it's got a hole that is unlocked. And if we hide that for a second and click on the red one, it is locked. If we do show all, everything comes back. And we can do Control G to group them. Notice the red one is still here. I'm going to hide it for a second, but now we've got that hole, so our launcher will work. If we bring them back with the view all cube and we unlock them, This is ready to go, but we need to change the measurements. I'm going to make it 2.75 for the thickness, and then I'm going to click on them and I'm going to do control down arrow so they are 5 millimeters below the project. Let's set this back to 1 millimeter. And let's grab our entire project and raise it up in the air. You can pick how high you want. I'm going to choose 50 above the ground. Friends, let's do F to fit view in case you're zoomed out as far as I am. We're going to add some pins so this stays in place. Hit your work plane, which is the letter W. Bring out a cylinder. Set it on that work plane, hold down shift and shrink it to size 3 and press enter. Notice when you shift shrink, it does the same amount on every side. We're going to get this pin close to the middle, do control D, get that one close to the middle. We're not worried about perfect on this one. And then we're going to shift select those two and choose group, which is also control G. We're going to move to the other side of that cube. Do the work plane, put it on that side, click on our little cylinders and do control D. With that work plane there, hit D to drop, and bingo, those are the pins that are going to create a little bit of friction and hold that in place. Now we need to bring out the target for our project. We're going to do this really slick by looking underneath those red ones, bringing out a cube, and because of cruising, we can set it right on those edges. We're going to take that cube and change its measurements. Instead of having it 20 wide, we're going to make it 10 wide and press enter. Everything else will keep the same. We do want these aligned, so we're going to shift click on those red pieces. We're going to choose the align tool, click on the red one to make it the boss. Let's look at it from the front, and we want it to be the center of the red ones, and we also want it to be the center this way. Notice if you zoom in a little bit more, you can find that much easier. If we look below, that is now absolutely groovy. Let's look underneath this again with this cube right here, and we are going to bring out a cylinder and we're going to cruise it to the bottom of that cube. We're going to hold down shift and we're going to scale it down and type the number 3, so it's just a small pin. And then we're going to shift click those two into a line, and we want it to be to the middle. And we want it to be to this front edge. We're going to do control D, and we're going to use the arrow keys to move that to the back. Once again, we want it to be to that edge as well. It doesn't have to be perfect, we just have to get it there. Friends, we have just created our trigger launcher. Let me show you how it works. Of course, the first step is to switch to the sim lab. When you enter sim lab, the parts are made out of plastic, and initially they're all set to move. If we click this button, we can make them static, so now this one cannot fall. We also want to take our pins, and we can shift click, so I've got both pins at once and I can make them static. And then finally the two pins below, shift click, we want to make static as well. I'm going to zoom out a little bit. I'm going to do shift right click to pan, and friends, here's how you test it. When you hit play, nothing moves. When you shoot at the target, bingo, you have got a launchable trigger. Isn't that awesome? You can slide it back and rewatch. Notice they sit there peacefully until bam, you hit your target and you have got a launchable project. How cool is that? Of course, friends, if we hit reset, we can start playing with materials. We were using completely plastic. Let's see if it can handle switching to something heavier like steel. I'm going to just hit play with one steel, one plastic. Notice this one had too much power and it popped out. That's because of those collisions, and having them opposite probably changed it as well. And if you really wanted to make steel, that's where you'd modify this, but at least we have it working with plastic. Let's see what happens if we make them both steel as we experiment with it. Once again, we hit play. Ooh, that stayed in place better, and it still auto-launched, but it was because of the pressure. Of course, there's a lot of room for you to play and make this more epic. I just want to show you one important thing for working with it. When you go back to the main Tinkercad workspace, Before you build your fun Tinkercad projects, I recommend you never break this one, but instead make a duplicate so that you can always go back to your main launcher. Alright everybody, so here is my idea for how you build these. I've got a lot of Domino tutorials. I'll make sure there are links in the video. As you can see, we still have our trigger down here. I added a ramp, the dominoes, and friends, it's time to test this in the sim lab. Of course, hit sim lab. We need to click on our new parts and make sure we set them to static. That one is static as well. I want to launch that trigger. Notice I can't shoot through here, so I'm going to spin down to the back. Let's hit play. Notice I messed that up. Let's go back and fix it. Reset. Bingo. Now I got it to static. Once again, hit play. They are stopped. Shoot. Down it goes. Ah, I bumped my dominoes. Hey, it still works. And then here's the coolest part, friends. After we hit pause, even though we launched it from behind, we can spin around and we can watch it from the front. How cool is that? I'm gonna find the spot right here where it gets triggered, hit play, and bingo, there is our sweet fun launchable domino run. Once again, I can hit pause, we can back it up and rewatch it. Don't forget, you can also hit share, pick the aspect you want, and export it as a video, either a small file or a large file. These are limited to 10 seconds. I do want to let you know that I've also created videos teaching you how to record your screen with Clipchamp so you can have much larger recordings of your Tinkercad SimLab creations. Don't forget, you can visit my website, HLModTech.com. I have got the page dedicated to Tinkercad, and right down here you can find all my SimLab lessons, or you can find my YouTube channel and scroll down and find the playlist for SimLab tutorials. Friends, before I wrap up, I do want to remind you that when you finish any project, if you want to share it with the world, you can instantly click up on this gear, choose properties. Of course, give it a name. Mine is going to mention that there will be a link you can copy and paste in a moment. Of course, add some tags so people can search for it. Remember, if you ever want me to see what you create, if you type HLMT23, I search that almost every day, and of course, I'll give you a reaction. Finally, scroll down and choose public, and then I always choose attribution, no derivatives, because I want you to come up here, find that tutorial link, and gain some epic skills. Finally, prove you're not a robot and save changes. Of course, it would make my day if you do those same steps with whatever you create so I can check out your fantastic Tinkercad projects. Finally, friends, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HL ModTech. Don't forget, you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button. And last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HL ModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.